Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. Very good day to you all. In this video, I'm going to talk about the chapter 2.4 Hardness from the Shikli Mechanical Engineering Design textbook. Okay, this is the topic I'm going to talk about. It is the chapter 2.4 Hardness. You can read it better in the books. I hope this video will give you some extra information for you, additional from what you learn from your class. Okay, this is the hardness. What is the hardness? It's resistant to material to indentation or penetration. Okay, it is important because it is a key property for material selection and quality control. Okay, the common hardness test is Rockwell and Brinell hardness test. Okay, you can see wherever you see throughout your life, the things that is tough. It is hardness. Okay, let's say you use a hammer to make a dent on the wall of your room. Okay, the wall is made of concrete. Okay, nothing happened to that wall. That wall is hardness. Okay, and finally, when the wall broken, it chipped. It become chip. Okay, it become penetration or it become dented. It is it has low hardness property and. That is what you see throughout your life. Okay, there are two types of hardness test, which is called Rockwell and Brinell hardness test. Okay, the Rockwell test is a standard ASTM E18 for Rockwell hardness test. It uses the diamond cone, okay, scale C and steel ball scale B. Okay, load application is 60 kilogram, 100 kilogram, and 150 kilogram based on scale. It is advantages is quick reading, user friendly machine. Okay, Rockwell test is suitable for steel. Okay, compare with Brinell hardness test. Brinell hardness test is used for hardened steel or carbide ball. Indentation tool is hardened steel or carbide ball. Measurement is load divided by indentation surface area. Characteristics, it requires calculation and more time consuming. But the difference is from Rockwell test, it is used for cost structure. What is cost structure? It's the brick, okay? Brick layer, the brick in Malay called batu-bata, okay? The brick, okay? The structure has cost structure inside it. Then you use Brinell hardness test, okay? And hardness and strength, material strength relationship, it is a non-destructive testing. Okay, both Rockwell and Brinell test are generally non-destructive. Okay, it's correlation with ultimate tensile strength. You can read this calculation inside the textbook. Okay, application is to estimate the material strength and during manufacturing and quality control. And consideration, data scatter and material variation need to be acknowledged. Okay, the thing is, when you use the Brinell test, I'm sure usually you will learn about hardness and Brinell test during your first year study. You will go into the laboratory, there will be lab technician and your lecturer will introduce you to the hardness and material testing machine. Okay, and then you do the experimental on it. Okay, whatever you choose the material, let's say it is a rod lah. Usually in many practices, in many laboratory, they use the rod. Okay, a cylindrical thing lah. You see the cylindrical rod. Okay, you see the cylindrical rod. There are the middle one and there are the edges one. Okay, you take the reading. And when you take the middle, you take in the middle only. When you take the edges, at the edges, and take the edges only, because it will give some differences. Most of the time, the middle edges will be, the middle one will be give more reading, higher reading, and the edges than the edges one. It's because the middle one will be compacted more lah, so that the reading at the middle of the cylinder or the whatever you test, okay, usually it is more higher than the edges one. Okay, this is the tips I can give to you lah, but you will learn better during your class lah. Okay, thank you very much. Inshallah, we meet in the next video. Thank you.